Yo, all of you on the internet need to calm down and leave Illymation alone. What is up, everybody? This is Chris from The Rewired Soul, where we talk about the problem, but focus on the solution. And if you're new to my channel is all about mental health. And what I like to do is pull different topics from the YouTube community to try to teach you how to improve your mental and emotional well-being. So if you're into that, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell. And today there are a few topics and problems, if you will, that we're gonna be covering. And like, y'all need to calm down. People are losing their minds on Twitter and Instagram over the recent Illymation videos for multiple reasons. By the way, quick note, in case you didn't know, my new book, Rewire Your Anger, is now out over on Amazon for $4.99, the low, low price. Get one for your family members for Christmas. But yeah, so Illymation is a creator who I just recently got into, and I've been covering her videos because I haven't been able to, not that I haven't been able to, but I just haven't done enough videos on trauma and abuse and all of that. So I'm glad that she's made these videos and spoken out about this so she can teach and educate others and raise awareness. But there's a couple things going on online that we really need to talk about, okay? The first one is this tweet that Illymation sent out. Another thing that should really go without saying, stop snooping through my pictures and asking, is this your ex? I took all the photos down because I knew people would want to be vigilantes. Which brings me to my next point. I do not advocate for doxing, harassment, intimidation, or violence. If you go out of your way to do this, you are not a good person. I do not condone this type of behavior. Doing this doesn't make you an advocate, it makes you no better than him. And most likely, you'll end up harassing the wrong effing person. Thanks. Like, you guys, okay, so, We need to understand how to help somebody who has gone through trauma and abuse. Like, I'm gonna keep saying this. I will keep saying this until the day I die. You are selfish. You are selfish by default. But Chris, I'm not selfish. I didn't do that. Why are you saying that about me? Well, you're self-centered because you thought I was talking about you. But anyways, like, if you're trying to go out and defend the honor of Illymation or someone you know in your life who has gone through abuse, that is selfish because you're doing it for you and not for them because they have asked you not to, all right? When it comes to, you know, knowing somebody who has gone through abuse, like, you have to meet them where they're at. You need to talk to them. They need to tell you, right? Like, when somebody who's been abused tells you, like, no, I don't want anything to do with them, I'd rather not think about it, like, who are you? Who are you to say, no, I wanna go get revenge for you, right? And like, I get it. It's a disgusting, terrible thing that happened, and hopefully justice comes. But it is the abused decision, whether they're going to press charges, whether they're going to, you know, seek justice or whatever that is. Like, you cannot force somebody to do that. The best thing that you can do is be there for that person and support their decision. But one of the biggest issues is that so many people try to play this like Captain Save a Person type deal, and things go wrong, things go nuts. That's why you need to simmer down. Quit doing things for you and doing them, and start doing things for other people. Start thinking about what they want, what they need, okay? So real quick story time. So I used to date before my beautiful girlfriend Tristan. I used to date this girl who worked at a modeling agency. It was like a very, it was a specialized modeling agency, right? So one of the young women that she worked with, like, nobody was allowed down to their set, like the photo set, right? Like, nobody was allowed down there, okay? Except it, like, for the photographers, the bosses, and the models, okay? And one day, this woman's boyfriend comes down, like, kicking down the door, like he's like some like white knight in shining armor, and he's like, come on, babe, I'm gonna save you. You don't need to take these kind of pictures anymore. I got you, right? And she's like, what are you doing? And this jackhole was trying to rescue her. So two things happened. She got fired and she dumped that dude, all right? So quit trying to save people who don't want you to save them, okay? But yeah, in the case of Illymation, like, I couldn't find the other post, but I was looking looking at her Instagram stories, and like, you guys, like, it's crazy. It's crazy what's happening right now. People have accused Illy Mation's friends of being this ex from the video. People have accused her current boyfriend of being the ex from the videos. Like, y'all need to calm down and figure out something better to do with your time. The reason she made these videos was to process it herself and to increase awareness and warn other people so they can beware of warning signs, okay? She did not make this video so you could strap on your cape and try to save somebody. Now this next tweet, this next one, which she put in notes, really breaks my heart. Look, I can answer every question you have about my story, but there will still be someone saying, this is fake, you're lying. I could post pictures or other sensitive information of him and I, but there would still be someone saying, this is fake, you're lying. I could release private legal documents and records, essentially doxing myself to prove this happened, but there will still be someone saying, you're lying. Call me a liar or slander someone faking something for views. Tell me how, if it really happened, then you would X, Y, and Z to prove it. Therefore, you are a liar. Say it, it's fine, I don't care. If you don't believe I was abused, that's fine. Go support the survivors you do believe. If I didn't stack up to who a victim of assault truly is, then it should be easy for you to identify who is and isn't a victim. So go support them. You present yourself as an expert on this. So please step up and educate. Drop a GoFundMe link to someone who's fled their abuser and has nowhere to go. Share a news story about someone whose case was erroneously thrown out. Advocate for overturning a bill in your state that makes the sentences of these crimes harder. Spread awareness you claim to care so much about. Or accept my story as fiction, that's fine too. Fictitious tales can still have morals, life lessons, educational benefits. Leave it at that, then bye. I like this sass. Dang, like, I don't know what it is. I don't know, but through this journey, Illy Mation has just become one of my favorite people. But you guys, like, this is what's messed up. Like, do you remember when Dr. Christine Blasey Ford, you know, had to go testify, right? Like, that is crazy. She knew what was going to happen. Same thing with Illy Mation. She did this knowing that people were going to say this to her, and she still did it anyways. And like, going back to what I was saying about being selfish and self-centered, like, Illy Mation is an example of somebody who is trying to be selfless, right? She is putting herself, her own mental health at risk, knowing that some D-bags on the internet are gonna accuse her of lying just so she can help others. But I love how she calls out these freaking virtue signalers who act like they care. And this is what I talk about all the time. Like, there are so many people who just wanna sit there, whine, complain, and moan, but when was the last time, like she said, where these people spread some awareness on their own or started to raise money for abuse survivors, right? Or went to go donate to a women's shelter or whatever it is. Like, and I know, like, right now it probably seems like I'm virtue signaling, but I'm just like trying to think logically here, right? Like, it is just insane. It is just insane. Like, you guys, like, it is not your place. It is not your place as some random person on the internet to say that someone is lying about something like this, all right? Like, that is not your place. Like, do you really wanna be the jerk who turned out to be wrong accusing somebody of lying about something like this? Like, let that sink in for a second, you guys. Like, trauma is a very real thing, and it is disgusting how many people are a victim of it, all right? So relax. Calm down, get educated, and ask survivors what you can do to help them, okay? But anyways, that's my little rant. If any of you would like to share down in the comments below, if you would like to, like, let me know. Do you like when people try to save you, to try to be the hero and come in and, you know, be all like a superhero? Like, let me know down in the comments, because maybe I'm totally wrong. Maybe I'm wrong, but I don't think I am. Okay. Anyways, that's all I got for this video. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up. If you're new, make sure you subscribe and ring that notification bell, because I make a ton of videos. And a huge thank you to everybody supporting the channel over on Patreon. You are all amazing. And everybody over on Patreon at the $20 tier and up, my book, Rewire Your Anger, is now available for free download over there as a perk for you. All right, thanks again. I'll see you next time.